y'all. Today we're going to talk about how to read a research article like a shark. Now, the first thing it's going to have is a title. Now, any good shark movie has a whole lot of fake blood. And for today's shark movie, we have a can of V8. It's fake blood. Now, by this title, it should be a car engine, should it not? Nope, not an engine, a tasty vegetable drink. So please note that the title may not be an accurate representation of what the article is actually about. Next up, we have the abstract. Now the abstract is something you have to read, but it's not the same as reading the whole darn article. So please don't cite an article if you only read the abstract, because the abstract has a lot of things in it that have to get smooshed down to like 150 words. So it's a whole lot like your gummy multivitamins. Now you may think if you eat the multivitamins that you don't have to, you know, eat anything else but nachos for like all the rest of your life, and you'll have all that you need to be getting in. But you might not be absorbing everything that you need from those vitamins, just be peeing out a lot of your daily value or whatever. So a multivitamin is good, an abstract is good for insurance, but that does not take the place of reading the full article and or eating vegetables. All right. The next thing after the abstract is the introduction and the literature review part. Now that's like your appetizer, like some yummy, salty, fishy crackers. Okay. But now if you've eaten these yummy, salty, appetizer fishy crackers, you won't have space or time left to actually get into the main course. So read that introduction and the lit review part to get a nice overview of what's going to happen. But don't like go deep into spending a whole lot of time on it. All right, now that you've done had your appetizer, you now need to think about the main course. And a lot of people may argue that the main course of an article is the results and conclusions and discussion part. I don't think so, and neither does Sharky right here. To us, the main course is the methods, the methodology, the method part, whatever the authors may call it. That talks about how they did their research study. Now to me, that's a main course. That's where you can find out, like, were they overly biased? Like, somebody might have a bias, like saying that their dog is the best ever. I know that's not true because Sharky is the best dog ever. Fact. Anyway, so with the main course, you can have you a yummy shark burger. And you can put you some tartar sauce on it. The tartar sauce is like how they talked about doing the research and what all they were trying to find out, the steps in their research and what they did in the lab or the clinic or wherever. And you want to look at it deep, because this is where you can find out, is this a good study? As a new researcher, you may not totally know. That's again why you need to look at multiple articles across, you know, a topic. But let's say that you have this here shark burger and you're getting ready to eat it. Yummy. You need to now go from the main course and add in your results. Look at the results. Now in this strange metaphor, the results are going to be the bun. Because who all eats a plush shark burger with a fork? Not me. You need something to keep you from getting the tartar sauce on your hands. And why not use bread? Okay. So anyway, you spend your most of your time eating the main course. Really work in the whole, like, you know, sharky burger. You eat up on that. You spend time on the results too. That's like the bun, but you're really working on that sharky burger. Okay, for that discussion and conclusion part, that's like your dessert. In this case, some yummy Swedish fish. Now, this dessert is meant to be so tantalizing that you're just gonna wanna read it before everything else and then get all filled up and not eat the rest of the food that you were supposed to have eaten before you got to the dessert. Oh, and the dessert can be yummy and tasty and ooh, so yummy. But it's really nowhere near what you need to actually understand the full article. So don't start with your dessert. save that till the end, because they're gonna fill it full of sugars and artificial colors and flavorings in order to make you want to read it first and to make that whole article sound better. Okay, now for the references part of the article. Usually, you think you might want to skip it. References are actually important. They're like the ingredients on this here dessert. While the front of your dessert or your article may say, ooh, good stuff, like fat-free, ooh, and it's fish, so these are healthy. Look at the ingredients, look at the references. In case you need to find out more about your topic, find other things to read, also find out if those authors that quoted these folks or that cited these folks may have misinterpreted their own readings thereof, and you may find some interesting things like sugar and invert sugar and modified cornstarch and mineral oil. Okay.